Hi student, welcome to botany class. Today we are going to see the mycorrhiza. So what is the mycorrhiza? So it's nothing but it's a fungus. The fungal is associated with the higher group of plants. The fungus, it is associated with the higher group of the plants, especially the symbiotic relationship, that is called mycorrhiza. So what is the mycorrhiza? It is a fungus. It symbiotically associates with the higher group of plants. So the higher group of plant, it will be provide the shelter and food to the fungus. For that, the fungus, it will be absorb the water and minerals from the soil and supply to the plants. Okay, so it's a symbiotic relationship. When the fungus is associated with a higher group of plants, mean that is called mycorrhiza. Okay, let's enter into the topic. The symbiotic association between the fungal mycelium and the root of plants, especially the higher plant, is called mycorrhiza. It's a symbiotic relationship. We already know that the fungi is a heterotroph. Is not able to prepare the food material. Okay, so that's why it depends on the plant for the food and shelter. For that, the plant, the fungal, it will be help to absorb the more amount of water and minerals to the plant. The plant, it provide the shelter and the food to the fungal. So there is a mutual relationship. A symbiotic relationship. Okay, so in this relationship, the fungi absorb the nutrient from the root. It absorb the nutrient because it is a heterotroph. It's not able to prepare the food material. Okay, so that's why it get the nutrient from the root. In turn, the hyphae network of the mycorrhiza, it forming the fungus, that is, it help the plant to absorb water and mineral nutrients from the soil. So this mycorrhiza fungal is help the plant to absorb more amount of water and mineral nutrient from the soil, and the plant, it provide nutrition to the fungus. Fungus, it will be provide the plant help to absorb the more amount of water and mineral from the soil. For that, the plant, it supply the nutrition to the fungus. So here the whole the organism are mutually beneficial. So that is a symbiotic association between the fungal mycelium and the higher plant roots. So the types. So first one we are going to see that ectomycorrhiza. Ecto, the term itself has a meaning. Ecto mean outside. Endo mean inside. Okay, so this fungus. So symbiotic association fungus is called mycorrhiza. So this mycorrhiza, it present the surface of the root, and also it will be penetrate inside, not very deep but very little, in the intercellular space of the epidermis or the cortex. Okay, so the fungal mycelium is formed the dense sheet around the root is called mandrel. Okay, wait a minute. So this is the dense sheet, it will be formed around the root, that is called mandrel. So the hyphae network is penetrate the intracellular space of epidermis and cortex to form the hot ring, to form the hortic ring or net. Okay, so that is a hortic net. So here it will be given. So it's a dense mandrel, that is a dense fungal association, it presents the surface of the root, that is a mandrel. So this haustoria, it will be penetrate inside the epidermal and the cortex, especially for intercellular space, and is formed the hortic net. Okay, so that is a ectomycorrhiza. So it presents the outer surface it form the densit, that is a mandrel, and when it is penetrate to form the aortic net. Example, the isthmus pectoralis. And next, endomycorrhiza. The hyphae grow mainly inside. Very clear. It mainly grow inside. But here, we can see that ecto, the fungal mycelium is formed dense seed around the root, that is outer surface, around the root. But here, the hyphae grow mainly inside the root and penetrate the outer cortical cell of the plant root. So, the small portion of the mycelium is formed outside the root. Only a small portion is present outside the root. So, remaining entire portion is present inside the root. But here, a small portion is present inside the root. Remaining entire portion of the fungal mycelium is present outside the root. So, that is endo. Endo means the fungal mycelium is present inside the cortical layer. Okay, only a little portion is present outside the root surface. This form, that is the endomycorrhiza, this form is generally called BAM fungi, vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi. Vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi. So, due to presence of the vesicle and the arbusculars. So, what is the vesicle and arbuscular? So, the finger like projection is present inside the cortical cell, that is arbuscular. And a small sac like structure, it's also present inside the cortical cell, that is a vesicle. Okay, so arbuscular means the finger like projection, vesicle means a small sac like structure, it's more or less spherical. Okay, that is a vesicle. So these two are present, express the host. What is the host? It's nothing but it's a filamentous fungal body, it will be adapt to absorb nutrients. It is a filamentous structure. It is a hyphae, but it will especially modified to absorb the nourishment from the root. Okay, that is a haustoria. Okay, so in the haustoria, both vesicle and arbuscular is present. That is a BAM fungi, especially endomycorrhiza. So the endomycorrhiza is generally called BAM fungi. Example for endomycorrhiza means BAM fungi is a best example. These are the types of the endomycorrhiza, the arbuscular mycorrhiza, AM. So, BAM, vesicular and arbuscular. But it's a only arbuscular, that is AM. Example, Chindrigospora. And the ericoid mycorrhiza, example, Iridodendron. Orchid mycorrhiza, example, Rhizotonia. So, these are the different type of the endomycorrhiza present in different group of plants. For example, the orchid mycorrhiza is present only in the Orchidaceae family. Only in the Orchidaceae family. Okay. So, these are the different mycorrhiza. That is arbuscular mycorrhiza. That is a finger like projection. So, that is ericoid mycorrhiza. So, this is orchid mycorrhiza. So, the another mycorrhiza, that is ectoendo. Ectendo. That is, it is present in the outer surface and also it present inside the cortical layer. So, previously we have discussed ectomycorrhiza and endomycorrhiza. Now, we are going to see ectendomycorrhiza. So, ectendo means some amount of or some part of mycorrhiza is present. Now, the fungal body is present in the surface of the root and some part it present inside the root, especially the cortical layer. The fungus is formed both the mandrel, mandrel means outer surface, the dense seed, that is a mandrel, and also it penetrates the cortical cell. So, that is called is an ectendomycorrhiza. Okay, so here they will be clearly given the ectendomycorrhiza, it forms the seed, that is a mandrel. So, that is a epidermis, it is a cortex region. And it penetrates the intercellular space and present the cortex layer. Okay, so that is ectendomycorrhiza. It's a ectomycorrhiza. It only present the dense in the outer surface and some amount only penetrate the intercellular space. But here, it's a endomycorrhiza. So, a little portion is present outside, so remaining entire portion penetrate inside. So, that is, it's a valve fungi, that is arbuscular, that is a arbuscular mycorrhiza, it is ericoid mycorrhiza, it is orchid mycorrhiza. So, here this picture is clearly given. So, it's a seed, a mandate, and this is a word. The filamentous structure, that is ostoria, it will penetrate inside the cortical layer. That is arbuscular. Okay, it's an external hyphae, it present inside. Okay, so that is ectendomycorrhiza. Next, the importance of mycorrhiza. So, what is the main group? So, we already know that it will be helped to absorb the more amount of water and minerals for the root. It will be enhanced the absorption of more amount of water and minerals. Which one? The fungus. To enhance the root to absorb more amount of water in the mineral salt. Okay, so apart from this mycorrhiza is do the various role. Especially, it helps to derive the nutrition in monotropha. So, what is the monotropha? It is a saprophytic angiosperm. It is very clear. So, all the angiosperm are photosynthetic except a few. So, among them, the monotropha is a saprophytic angiosperm, that is very, very important. They do not have chlorophyll pigment. So, that's why it will be depends on the date and decaying matter. So, how can it absorb the water and minerals and food material from the date and decaying matter? In the presence of the haustoria from the fungus or mycorrhiza. This mycorrhiza is associated with monotropha. It is sent to absorb the food material from the saprophytic or dead and decaying matter of the plants and animal. So, monotropha is a saprophytic angiosperm. It's another role of the mycorrhiza. And also, it's helped to improve the ability of the minerals and the water to the plant. So, how it will be increase the ability of minerals and water to the plant means? When the infection will be occur in the root surface mean, as a result, the root hair, it will be enlarged in the size. The mycorrhiza is penetrated inside the root hair only, not any other part, only it will be entered through the root hair. Okay, so when infection will be occur, that means the mycorrhiza is associated with the root hair mean, the surface of the root hair will be increased. When the surface of the root hair will be increased mean, automatically the absorption of water and mineral salt also increase. Okay. And it provides the drought resistant to the plants. So, it helps to resist the drought condition to the plants. And also it protects the root of the higher plant from the attack of the plant pathogen, especially for root pathogen. So, when the mycorrhiza is associated with the root mean, the particular plant or the particular root is not affected by the root pathogen. Because this mycorrhiza, it will be prevent the attack of root pathogen. So, these are the importance of mycorrhiza. Thank you, student.